Hello friends, welcome back. Go through the previous two videos where we started the application of first law of thermodynamics for non-flow process. This is the third video on numerical on non-flow process. Let's start with the first numerical. This numerical is asked in GATE 2013. Okay, let us see. A cylinder contains 5 m³ of an ideal gas at a pressure of 1 bar. This gas is compressed in reversible isothermal process. So it is the isothermal process, okay, till its pressure increases to 1 bar. So initial volume is 5 m³ and pressure P1 is 1 bar. The gas is compressed isothermally to increase the pressure up to 5 bar. The work in kilojoule required. Okay. V1 is given, P1 is with us, P2 is with us, and they ask isothermal work. Okay, we know that the isothermal work for fundamental formula is P1 V1 log to the base E V2 upon V1. Okay, but the only one volume is with us, V1, V2 is not given, or also they're not given any hint for calculating V2, but we know the general gas equation. P1 V1 upon T1 is equal to P2 V2 upon T2, where isothermal process T1 is equal to T2. So we get one relation, P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. Okay. So if you use this relation for ratio V2 upon V1, for V2 upon V1, we get P1 upon P2. So this ratio we can replace P1 V1. Log to the base E P1 upon P2, and the required answer in the kilojoule. Okay, first put the value of pressure in bar, so 1 bar, but we need in Newton per meter square, so 1 × 10⁵, that is the pressure. Then volume is the 5 m³. Log to the base E, we use ln, both pressure with us. 1 bar, P1 is 1 bar upon 5. There is no need to convert into Newton per meter square, because if we convert, there is no problem. They cancel each other. So we put the values. Okay. We get calculation. I am going to take calculation here. 1 × 10⁵ × 5 ln in bracket 1 upon 5. Okay, we get the answer here, -80.4718.95 joule. Okay, we can also write -804.718 × 10³ joule. Okay, our answer is negative. If we see the reverse iso process and the compression process, if you see here, compression process is going on. So its work is done on the system. So already our work is negative. Okay. So that negative becomes now positive. So we can also write 804.71, and that is the kilojoule, and that is the option is A. So this is very simple. In GATE questions, they are all the straightforward numericals, but we have to remember the basic fundamentals for each process so you can get the answer. This is the GATE question 2013. Hopes you understood. I will take the next numerical. A rigid and insulated tank, 0.1 m³ volume, contain nitrogen at 325 Kelvin and 1.2 bar. An electrical resistor is placed inside the tank. Is very important. This is a very, very important numerical. Now we see Electrical resistor placed inside the tank is connected to a battery and current flows through the resistor till the temperature of the gas is raised 375 Kelvin. Okay, see here, what is the condition? A rigid vessel, a rigid insulated tank. Insulator is very important again, and the tank is rigid, so there is no change in volume. So number of students, see that is a constant volume process, correct? This is a constant volume process. Okay, certain mass of gas, that is nitrogen, is there. We supplying to heat that nitrogen gas through resistor coil. We provide across that coil, we providing one batteries there. Okay, so it in that case is work is done on the system. I again told, in that case we work is done on the system. But we know that for constant volume process, work done is zero. I previously told that because constant there is no change in volume. Okay, work is done by the system is zero. I again repeat, work is done by the system is zero. But in that case, we work is done on the system. So what amount of you done in this case? This is the negative. The work is done on the system. The system is not given any kind of work. Okay, the system is not given any kind of work here because this rigid volume is very important. So we can't get directly, not written as directly work as a zero. We see the question carefully, read the question carefully, determine the work done. And final pressure of gas in the tank. Okay, determine the work done. They ask electric work. So we need fundamental formula again. Heat supply utilized for change in internal energy and work done. Okay, here work is negative. Also, there is a insulated tank. So Q is a zero. So du, and this work is negative. So I can write like that. So the equation becomes minus du is equal to minus dw. So we get du is equal to change in work done. So we can calculate work done such that direct is change in internal energy, that is mcv delta t. Okay, so here, see now what are the parameters they given. Once a minute. Okay. Now we see how we calculate the remaining two parameters. First, we calculate M and CV. Two temperatures they given. There's the temperature T1 and T2. Let's see how we calculate M and CV now. Okay, for calculating M and CV, first we need R. Okay, why R? For calculating M, the V is going to use basic formula PV is equal to MRT. Again, M is not given. So every time if M is not given, okay, not mentioned per kg, okay, we use directly basic formula PV is equal to MRT. For that purpose, we need first R. So they given one hint. So we know that basic formula Ru is equal to Mr. So R is equal to Ru upon M. So you know it's a gas constant or molar gas constant. We remember this value 8314 for nitrogen. Molecular mass is the 28. First calculate R in the form of joule per kg Kelvin. Always remember by using this formula, I'm going to calculate M. Pressure is there given. Is 1.2 bar converted newton per meter square. Volume is there. Rigid insulated tank V1 is there. Are we calculate an initial temperature? So mass of that gas initially. So mass we calculate for calculating CV. CV is equal to CV mole upon M. If we see here, for nitrogen gas, the molar heat capacity at constant volume is 5/2 R mole. where R mole is universal gas constant. Okay, the CV, the specific heat, they're not directly given specific heat, they're given CV mole. Okay, they're directly given CV mole, and the CV mole is nothing but is the 5 by 2 R mole. Okay, so for calculating CV, formula is CV mole upon M, and the CV mole is the given one relation, that is 5 by 2 R molecule, that is 5 by 2 of universal gas constant, that is RU, or R we can say R mole. And so R mole is nothing but here 8314. So we calculate first CV. The numerical is very simple. These are only two unknowns. There is a hint for this numerical. And also I told that electric work is there, but work is done on the system. So first we calculate now the change in internal energy, MCV delta T, MCV delta T. Since the tank is insulated, so dq is equal to 0. Again, I repeat in previous slide also. So what amount of change in internal energy? That is the work done. Okay, that minus and cancel each other is work is done on the system. So work done is around 4.61 kilojoule. The rigid vessel implies that the change in state. So also it is an isochoric process. So general gas equation P1 upon T1 is equal to P2 upon T2. That's final pressure. Use this basic formula. T1, T2 is with us. P1 is with us. So we can calculate P2. Okay. Hope these two numericals we understood. Okay. Then stop. In further video, we see the another different numericals. Thank you.